share the shadow to my light. Did you feel us? Another star, you fade away. Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see us alive. Where are you now?
Was it all in my fantasy? Where are you now? I'm so good. desperate. We are not able to find a bike which can do this stretch. So that's when the January came in and we were like desperate. Practically sleepless nights with all the other things going on, and we still haven't finalized on the bike. So January came and finally the Domino was launched and we had a look at the spec sheet. And that's when we thought this bike makes a lot of sense for us, because we didn't want to touch any of the engine or the transmission part at all. Whatever the factory does, any company, that's the best possible performance tune for the particular machine. So we didn't want to tamper that. And the forks, the suspension, it was perfect. Again, the BT forks, suspension was fine, the alloys were tested well enough. So the basic factory was good and the damp range was decent for us, 300 plus kilometers. And then all we had to do was add the external modifications which made the package complete. So that's how we arrived at the bike.
So one more thing. So basically the Sharon Canyon was one of the difficult, most terrain that we have heard. So what exactly was running through your mind and how did you go? Because going to the fact that no one has actually done it, and this is actually like bad for two-wheelers to be done. So how, what actually made you do that?
I'll tell you what went on through my mind. Yeah, so the scene was something like this. So when we reached the national park, it was around 5:30 in the evening, I guess. Yeah. So kind of dusky, but we still had about a few more hours of daylight. So we went around the park. The cops allowed us to go to a circuit. We could go to the top of the cliff and then come back. So then we thought, why don't we just go out and check? There's a place where you've seen some of the adventure touring videos where they enter the base of the canyon. And if you head out in the base, you go right for about 3 kilometers. There's a cafe and the camping spot. So we thought it might be a good idea to check. But then at the entry, they told this place is strictly off limits. Do not go. Motorcyclists have been seriously injured. So then we entered the face of this particular descent. Then we saw and evaluated. So one thing was, the factor was, we didn't really want to waste that much of time in taking 3 bikes down all the way, because the cliff descent was about this. So the videos won't show justice, because videos never show the perception of depth, right? Incline or descent. So it was this slanting, and then it had the corrugations on it, and then you can't even brake. The moment you brake, it just starts sliding down. So even with 3 of us, holding and pushing or pulling, the bike still used to roll down. So that was the moment where we decided we'll take one bike down and DK did it.
Well, obviously I take adventure now. I don't blog, very little. Very critical and crucial points is something I do. I don't have the habits of watching somebody else's experience. Talking about myself beforehand. So I firmly believe that, you know, like, take adventure head on. So we have a breakdown, we have a breakdown. How many of you guys have been riding around to Leh-Ladakh and different parts of the country and still faced a breakdown? Might not be on the Dominar because it's just launched. So any other bikes before that? Any of you? Been out on a ride, you had a breakdown, you had to try fixing it, call for help. Come on, don't tell me. Yeah, be frank. I mean, it's part and parcel of the adventure. I mean, I firmly believe that. So, the Sharon Canyon was very new, considering that, yeah, we were strictly warned by the National Park cops not to go down there, because there have been videos where people have regretted of having gone down, heavy bikes, not able to go down properly, still venture to go down but not able to come back. So, obviously, you know, like, these were the very strong discussion that happened. You know, they're very heated on, right? I'm sure, like, boys, you know, have thought the bigger picture was Magadan. Definitely, the bigger picture was Magadan. But then, if we have an adventure that's coming in midway, let's take it down. What happens, Jehovah's Witness. And that's my opinion. So, yes, we did. The road was really bad. What was the confidence level that I had? And I'm very brutal in saying this. The bike is weighing 180 kgs. And if you see the bike that I took down, I had technically stripped it down. There's no legal number. So which means to say, you know, like, I'm taking a stock Dominar down. except the saddle stays and on the box again. So we had done roughly around about 4,000 kilometers before reaching Shan. So we knew at least like how the bike is taking it. We had just changed the air filters. No servicing was done. So there was enough power through throttle in case of a worst case emergency. The dirtiest part of this drop is within the first few meters, there is a sharp left. So you're not able to control this down, you just roll down. And it's not easy for even three of us to hold the bike and struggle to take it on the corner. It's not. So that's where the engine braking comes into the picture. And that's where the little amount of experience that I had also came into the picture. Plus the help that these guys were trying to hold it back, pull it back, also came into the picture. So all this put together is something that that's an experience that I really want. So there's no way back. So after the first lap, then I don't know what. Going down. So his question was, what do you want to go going down there? Well, let's see what happens. And we'll never see tomorrow, right? How many of us have seen tomorrow? We all live for today. So that's exactly what I had. And let's see and do it. Braking was brilliant. Of course, again, having said this, guys, I must admit that the tires play a super dominant role in these kind of running. So please do not. I might be inspiring and encouraging you, and I'm trying to tell you this, but do not try without a proper tire. The stock tires that you get are regular production. So in case you want to do something different, the tires must go. It plays a very, very vital role. And then that helps with the the ABS that comes into picture. The weight of the bike is definitely a positive sign that this bike is fine. So all this put together is the confidence that I'm getting to share it with you.
Actually, when we have been interacting with people, that's just the standard question that we've been asking. Like, what are the tires that we should go for? So the question that I is the self-evaluation that you'll have to do, whether how much of off-roading that you're going to do, and if you measure motion. See, just because these bikes have it, you don't actually have to buy these tires and run them on it. So it is a case-by-case scenario. You see, if you have major of your planning is on the off-road conditions, then you get these tires. Otherwise, production tires do survive well.
So with this, I'll open the session for all the audience to ask questions and interact with our riders.